Hi everyone, in this video we will discuss all the type C questions of chapter 2, that is Python fundamentals from Computer Science with Python class 11. Now write a program that displays a joke but display the punchline only when user presses the enter key. So for that purpose you have to take one string as input from the user, and let's say we are storing it in a variable called joke. So within that you can just write a line, enter the punchline. Then it will ask you to enter the punchline. Then after that it will print that one. So once you run this, then it will ask you to enter the punchline. There you can write your punchline. So here I have written the 5 days after weekend is hardest. So we can just put that one. Then that will be printed. Now write a program to read today's date and display how many days are left in the current month. Now let's say there is a variable day which will take the date. So since it is a numeric value, so we have converted it into integer like this by using int function. Now within input you just pass enter today's date. So only date you have to pass. Now days left is equal to, you can just write 31 minus day if it is the month is a 31 days month, or else you can write 30 minus day, anything is fine. So I have written 31 minus day, and I have kept it in another variable days underscore left. So it will print number of days left in current month is equal is days underscore left. So once you run this program, it will ask you to enter today's date, and here suppose you have asked the value as 2. And it will print the number of days left in current month is 29. Now write a program to generate the following output 5, 10, 9. That means you have to take a variable and assign it with 5. Then multiply it with 2 to get 10. And then subtract 1 from it to get 9. Now again modify the above program so that it will print 5 at the rate 10 at the rate 9. So let's say there is a variable a which is initialized with 5. Now it will just print a. Now b is equal to a into 2. That means a is multiplied by 2 and that is stored in a variable b. Now it will print b. Now c is again another variable which is b minus 1. Now it will print c. So like that it will print the values of a, b and c in different lines. Then the fourth program also we can do in the same program, that is modify this one so that it will print 5 at the rate 10 at the rate 9. So you can just print a comma at the rate, you have to keep within the quotes, then comma b, then comma again at the rate symbol you have to keep within quotes, then comma c. Then you can see the output is like this. First it will print a, that is 5, then b, that is a into 2, that is 10, now c, that is 9. Now again it will print a at the rate b at the rate c in a single line like this. Now write a program with maximum 3 lines of codes that assigns first 5 multiples of a number to 5 variables and then print them. So here we have taken a variable 3 n which is initialized with 3. Now we will just take 5 multiples of 3, that means we will multiply it with 1, then with 2, then with 3, then with 4 and 5 to get 5 multiples. And all these multiples will be stored in different variables A, B, C, D, E. But since it is given that your lines of codes should be maximum 3, so we can just assign all these variables in a single line. So that can be written like this, the variables will be separated with commas. A, B, C, D, E, like this 5 variables are stored, and after that you have to assign the 5 respective values in the right side. That is the 5 multiples that you are getting after multiplying it with 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Then you can print the first 5 multiples of A and R, A, B, C, D, E, that is the first 5 multiples of 3 are 3, 6, 9, 12 and 15. Now, next program is to accept a radius and print the area of the circle. So for that, you can take a variable r, which is the value of radius will be entered by the user. So you can just write input, enter radius of the circle. and since it is a numeric value, we can convert it into int. Suppose if you want to give float value also, you can just write float in place of int. Now area is equal to 3.14 into r into r. Now it will print the area of the circle is area. So area is the variable which will store the area of the circle. So once you run the program, it will ask you to enter the radius. Suppose the radius entered is 9. So it will calculate the area of the circle is 254.34. Now write a program to accept marks in 5 subjects and prints average mark. So you can see there are 5 subjects here. I have kept the marks in 5 subjects and 5 different variables. Let's say the name of the variables are math, computer, physics, chemistry and English. So these are the variables which will store the marks in the corresponding subjects. So we are just giving this input, enter the marks in math, and we are converting the marks entered by the user into integer type. Here also, if you want, then you can take float type. Now after entering all the marks, it will calculate the average marks and it will store it in a variable, let's say avg_marks. So that will be math plus computer plus physics plus chemistry plus English. So these are the variables which are keeping the marks of the corresponding subjects. Those will be added and it will be divided by 5. Then you can print like the average mark is avg_marks. So while running the program, it will ask you to enter the mark in math, that is suppose let's say 98, then the marks also we have entered like this, and it will calculate the average mark is 96.6. Now next, you have to write a program to accept height in centimeter and convert it into feet and inches. So let's take a variable called height where the user has to input the height in centimeter. So the input statement is converted into integer by using int function. Now we have taken one variable called inches, which will store height divided by 2.54. So this is how we are converting centimeter into inches, because 1 inch is 2.54 centimeter. So whatever height is given in centimeter, if you divide it with 2.54, then you will get number of inches. So that is stored in a variable inches. Now we will convert inches into feet by dividing it with 12. Okay, so we will divide this inches value into 12, and whatever value you are getting, just to avoid the decimal values, you can use int function there. So that value will be stored in a variable f. Now I is equal to round inches percent 12. That means if you divide inches with 12 and whatever remainder you are getting, that will give you the inches. Now that means the first of all, the height in total inches. Now if you divide it into 12, whatever quotient you are getting, that is the feet, and whatever remainder you are getting, that is the inches. So the quotient you have got by dividing it into 12, and to avoid the decimal value, you just converted it into int. Then whatever remainder you are getting, that is actually the inches left. So that also you can just use a round function so that it will be rounded to the nearest integer. Now you can just print height is f feet and I inch. So let's say once you run the program, it will ask you to enter height in centimeter, and suppose you have passed the height as 162, then it will print height is 5 feet 4 inch. How it got it? It divided 162 with 12, and whatever quotient is there, that is feet. So sorry, for 162, first of all, it has to be converted into inches by dividing it with 2.54. So whatever value you are getting, that you have to divide with 12 to get feet, and the remainder is inches. Now write a program to read a number and print n square comma n cube comma n to the power 4. Now n is the number that will be entered by the user. Now it will print n to the power 2. So here we are using exponentiation operator, that is double star. Next it will print n to the power 3, then it will print n to the power 4. So while running the program, it will ask you to enter a number, and suppose the number entered is 4. So 4 square it will print as 60, then 4 to the power 3 is 64, and 4 to the power 4 is 256. Now write a program to calculate the area of a triangle. So here you can see, as you know, the area of a triangle is half into base into height. So first of all, you have to take the values of base and height, and we are storing it in variable b and h. So first of all, the user has to enter the base of the triangle, and that value has to be converted into int. And second, it has to enter the height of a triangle, which will be stored in a variable h. Now we will calculate area like this. Area is equal to 0.5 into b into h. Now it will print the area of the triangle is area. So once you run the program, you'll get the output like this. Enter the base of triangle, that is 5. Enter the height of triangle, let's say 8. These are the values given by the user. And when you run the program, you can give any value of your choice. Then it will calculate area of the triangle is 20. Now write a program to calculate simple interest and compound interest. So as you can see here, to calculate simple interest, you need to give three values, that is the principal amount, rate of interest, and time in years. So these three things we have taken in three variables, P, R, and T respectively. So first the user will enter the principal amount, then it will enter the rate of interest, then time. All these things are taken in integer, but if you want, you can take in float variable also. Now simple interest is calculated like this, P into R into T divided by 100. Now amount is equal to, you have to calculate amount to calculate compound interest, because compound interest is amount minus P. The amount formula is principal into 1 plus R by 100 to the power T. So this is the formula to calculate the amount of compound interest. So you have to just put the values P whole into 1 plus R by 100 to the power T. So compound interest is equal to amount minus principal. So finally you can print simple interest is SI, but while printing SI, it may give you long decimal values. So you can just use a round function. And here I have taken value as 2 so that the number will be rounded up to 2 digits. That means after decimal point, there will be 2 digits. Similarly, compound interest is round of compound interest 2. So you can see while running the program, it will ask you to enter the principal. Suppose here the amount entered is 5 lakh and the rate of interest is, let's say, 7. And time in years is, let's say, 4 years. And the calculated simple interest is 1,40,000, and similarly compound interest is also calculated like this. Now write a program to input a number and print its first five multiples. Now n is a variable where you will store the number entered by the user, and it will print the first five multiples are n, that means n into 1, that is same as n, then n into 2, then n into 3, n into 4, and n into 5. So once you run the program, it will ask you to enter a number, and suppose the number entered is 5, then it will print first 5 multiples are 5, 10, 15, 20, and 25. Now write a program to read the name class A's of a student and then print it. Details first in same line and then in separate lines having two blank lines in between. So we have taken three variables N, C, and A to store the name, class, and age respectively. Name will be taken as input from the user, and C class is also taken as input from the user, but it has to be converted into integer. Now A is age, which is also taken by the value is accepted by the user, and it is also converted into integer. Now it will print name, class, comma age, R, N, comma, C, comma, A. These are the variables which will be written separated by a comma. Now, as for the question, there are two blank lines. So you have to just write print with parenthesis, next print with parenthesis like this. Next, you have to print the name, class, and age in three separate lines. So you have to write it in three different print statements. So first statement, print name is N, then print class is C, then print age is A. So once you run this program, It will ask the user to enter the name. Suppose the name entered is Gopal and the class is 11 and the age is 17. Then it will print name, class, age are Gopal 11, 17. So these are all the values of the variable. Now just it will print two blank lines. Then after that it will again print name is Gopal, class is 11, age is 17 in three separate lines. Then write a program to input a single digit n and print n, n plus 1, n plus 2. That means if the entered digit is 7, then it will print 7, 8, 9. And n should not be more than 7. So here we have taken a variable n and we have given the statement, input statement, like enter any digit from 1 to 7. Then whatever value will be given by the user, just that will be printed like this, print n, comma n plus 1, comma n plus 2. So once you run this program, it will ask you to enter any digit from 1 to 7. And let's say the digit entered is 5, then it will print 5, 6, 7. Now write a program to read three numbers in three variables and swap first two variables with the sums of first and second and third numbers respectively. That means you have to take three variables, let's say A, B and C, which will store three different numbers which will be entered by the user while running the program. Now it will print first, second and third numbers are A, B, C. Now A has to be swapped with the sum of the first and second number. That means A will be replaced with A plus B. So you can assign A is equal to A plus B. Now the second number will be replaced by the sum of second and third numbers. So that means you can write B is equal to B plus C. So now print first, second and third numbers are A, B, C. Now let's see, once you run this program, it will ask you to enter the first number. Let's say that is 7. The second number is let's say 5 and third number is let's say 11. So the first, second and third numbers are 7, 5, 11. Now, first, second, third numbers are 12, 16 and 11. Why? Because first number is replaced by the sum of first two numbers, that is 7 plus 5, so that is 12. So now A value is 12. Now B value will be sum of B plus C, that is 5 plus 11, 16. So B is equal to 16. And C will be remain as it is, so C will 11. So this is how it will be. Now here ends the solutions of chapter 2 Python fundamentals type C. We have discussed all the questions of type C and stay tuned for more solutions and do subscribe. And if there is any doubt, you can put it in comment section also.